Alright, time to continue with some more of Baldur's Gate 3. Yeah? Alright, so.
I sense a touch of uncertainty, a touch of disgust.
So, this is where we left off last time. Let's see if we can explore our mind.
A shadow
swims across your vision, and a familiar voice tells you to be calm. You are loved. Lazelle's fear grips you, not fear of death, but fear of insignificance. The great warrior Lazelle, a failure of her kind, she will wield no silver sword, ride no red dragon, forever unknown to the great Lich Queen, Blackith. Save it here. Try to persuade her. This is an advantage? Wait. And the reason why I'm doing this is because I've read that in order to gain experience, you have to succeed in these speech things, so that's why I'm doing it this way. Not because I want to, but... Oh, okay, maybe because I want to. But that's just... Alright, there we go.
I came just in time. You are transforming.
Your salvation. And not for the first time. I saved you before.
And I'm here to save you again. Don't worry. You will not become a mind flayer. Not while I'm around. I'll protect you. We haven't much time, so listen closely. There is great potential within you. It comes from that parasite. Your instinct is to resist the power it gives, but you must accept it. Nurture it. I will keep it from consuming you, but for the sake of both of us, you must learn to wield it.
Thank you.
fight for the fate of Faerun. A fight we are losing. For now. You can change that, but only if you embrace your potential. I have to go. The enemy is closing in. I will be back. Wake now. You'll feel better. I promise.
Consuming parasites, general to you cannot consume mind flayer parasites from your inventory to unlock new illicit powers. Look out for sources of parasites in the world, including infected corpses. Interesting, to say the least. Thought I had some with me. Well, anyways, we better get back. Alright, so. Come on, you mugs. Guys? There's an exclamation point there. Oh, I see. Well, anyways.
Let's get going.
Guys? Why are we not following orders? Well, anyways.
No one back home will ever believe this.
Guys? Alright, let's go. Anyways, that's one goblin leader down. We got two more to go. And I think, since we killed the previous leaders, or the other groups, I wonder if this is gonna make our battles easier. Guess that's the one I asked for.
Thank you.
wonder if I can attack the drum.
Excellent.
Okay, so he can't call for help. Perfect. I'm gonna have to make a mental note of that, actually, now that I think about it.
Done for.
Well, we rescued him, so.
Breathe deep and move.
Again.
Stay focused.
Like I said, I'm gonna have to keep an eye on these drums from now on. That explains why. Mugs, let's go.
Traps, please. Light on my feet.
There's someone over here. Side.
Praise his ever-bleeding axe. Praise his throne of flaming iron. Praise Maglubiet.
You know Maglubiet.
You know Maglubiet, a tyrannical deity who treats his goblinoid followers as slaves.
Trying to interrupt my prayers? Scared of a real god? You're as goonless as the rest of them. I'm loyal to Maglubiet, cause I ain't having my head turned by some upstart god. They like feasting, fighting, and fornicating. Who doesn't? Absolute gives them that. Gotta know your place in the world, though. Maglubiet's kept us in line. That's what a god's supposed to do.
Mm-hmm.
You think this is funny?
Eh, that depends on how you look at it. Shot.
No.
little rat. Hey, little buddy. Interesting little tidbit of conversation.
Might as well take a look. Let's get on with it.
Oh.
Never a dull moment.
Can't afford to stay idle. I'll take this way.
Where's the little bloke who did this? One is directly above us. Where are you? You're standing on air. Nice shot. Nice shot. He's down for the count.
Yes.
Time to strike.
Wow, that was pathetic.
There's the only way.
And why were you picking on her? Jesus Christ. Oh my God. I might have to restart this. Ain't dead yet. Down for the count you go.
Let my name be known. There's an illithid parasite in that corpse. You should take a look.
Oof. That we can say we got lucky on. We're gonna definitely have to go back to camp. Nice. No allies for you. He doesn't know what to do now. So what spell should we teach him? Probably sleep would be a good idea. Play spells. Hold on. I'll take this out. Bring in Burning. We'll bring in something else. And a feat, huh? I think since because I use the bow on him more often, it'd be more advisable to use a sharpshooter. Yeah. Yeah, I think a sharpshooter would be best. Since I use bows with him mostly anyway, so that makes perfect sense. Now, where were we? Oh, yes. Oh, yeah, it's time to check out the Mind Flayer. I think that's two goblin leaders down, one to go.
This one is a true soul parasite. It can enhance you. You can absorb its potential. Open your mind to it. You already know how. Don't worry, you won't come to harm. I'll protect you.
Combined spells as it subsumes everything the temple has to offer. Everything it was and everything it was destined to be. Pure potential, pure power. Interesting.
Pure power. Good. You have grown your power and improved your chances of survival.
For now. For now. Oh, wait, hold on. Looks like Asterion wants to have a chat with me.
So, you've indulged. Just helped yourself to a little more power, I see. And there isn't a tentacle to be seen. Not a bad deal, I'd say. My only complaint is that you didn't want to share. I wouldn't mind indulging myself. I admit, I wasn't keen to be the first to try it, just in case there were any, surprise side effects. But now that we know it's safe, I'm all for experimenting.
The ladies might not agree with that.
I might just hold you to that.
Hmm. Well, anyways, let's, crossbow at.
Oh, enough waiting. I crave blood.
Still alive, so that's progress.
Who took the cross? Oh. Alright, anyways. That was quite a trip. You know, I don't think I'd be too sure if I can speak with the dead.
As the corpse rises,
your parasite squirms in recognition.
Stop it! Stop it! You wretched worm!
There's no doubt.
There's no doubt. This creature is responsible for your parasite, and it's waiting for your questions.
And it's waiting for your questions. Fractured images.
Fractured images fill your mind. Curved brow blades, crude goblin torches, gnarled teeth, dripping blood.
You see,
other mind players arranged in a strange circle. Absolute unity, absolute power.
Dark,
empty paths flicker across your vision. They demand new flesh.
They demand new flesh.
So this is question number 3.
You see drawn rags and read.
A tadpole clings to the mind player's fingers.
The goblin king bows,
obedient. The flesh of his tribe becomes the flesh of the absolute. See dark tunnels lit by noxious pools of brine. The darkness spreads through the earth.
The
sky splits open, and nautilites pour out of a void that consumes the stars. You see the tadpole in the mind player's hands. Not a parasite. Perfection. Rebirth is slow than flesh. A new skull is housing cold, sharp intellect. The mind flayer's corpse twitches and then collapses again. It will speak no more.
It will speak no more.
I was half expecting it to learn something new. Anyways, let's get back to camp here.
Ah, my good fellow. Quite the cozy setup you have here. I'll just make myself comfortable. Thank you so much. My research turned up a rather brilliant technique that seems quite actionable. It's not too deep, just behind the orbital socket. I could attempt an extraction. I've a needle in my tunic, after all.
Why'd you have a needle in your tunic? Oh, scalpel, more or less.
I assure you, I've dreamt of it 1,000 times over.
Dreaming and doing are not the same things, my friend. I want to get a second opinion
you
on this.
You won't find a more learned opinion on this matter, I assure you.
Well, before I do anything stupid, I'm going to save it here. Just for grins, giggles, and curiosities, I'm just going to do it. Volo carefully holds one of your eyes open and begins to prod uncertainly with the needle.
Don't fidget. The needle must slip behind your eye, not through it.
The needle finds the gap between eyeball and socket. Volo frowns and begins to push. Pain shoots through your body as the needle snags on your optic nerve.
I think I have it!
The needle seesaws back and forth, plucking the nerve like a harp string.
Oh bother. There's some obstacle in the way. I shall need a more robust implement.
Volo carefully withdraws the needle from your eye, then reaching to his bag, he produces an ice pick. Oh, this is real pleasant! Oh, this is real nice. Volo slowly brings the ice pick closer to your eye.
Now, don't move.
Cold metal presses against the skin beneath your brow, and then
tap, tap, stab.
I agree. It's a feisty critter. Just a little further.
Volo tears the pick from your brain, but violently your eye plops down into the mud.
Dread.
He pauses,
looks down at your eye and recoils slightly as it sinks into the mud. Lovely! I involuntarily got murdered. He pauses, looks down at your eye and recoils.
There appears to be an amount of cosmetic damage.
Thanks to you.
Please, try not to overexert yourself. You're in a rather fragile state at present. I can't help but feel partly responsible. Perhaps there is something more I can do. Take this. A far superior relic to that old jelly you were chained to. Try it on for size. And, it was very nice to have met you. I'm sure you'll sort out your little brain problem one way or another. Far away from here, if you've a heart. Terribly sorry, my friend. Ta.
Well, that's a good thing I saved. So I don't think we want to get Lazelle's disapproval anymore than we already got.
You won't find a more learned opinion on this matter, I assure you.
On second thought, let's not do this.
You only have a matter of days to live. Don't dally, my friend.
right. Oof. What's going on? Oh.
I'm ready. Whatever it takes.
Oh, don't tell me I'm... Am I frozen?
You carry a Githyanki relic.
Oh.
I will have an explanation. Or your head.
Walk away. Now. I won't warn you again.
Remove yourself if you are so easily offended. This is not your concern.
Nonsense. You're just finally showing us what you really are. A reaver to the bone.
Spare your indignity. Every word that spills from your mouth is worth less than the last. Incorrect. Judicious bloodletting settles feuds and roots out the weak, the deceitful.
Do you hear this, Tripe? Our lives are at stake, and she wants us to turn on each other.
No others. Just you and me.
Lady, there's no cat
fight. Isabel thinks I have something important to her people. She's deluded, clear.
Lies. She carries an heirloom of my people. I must know why.
I doubt this one's wit will be any sharper by then.
I do not wish to spill blood here. Come daylight, we will find a place to end.
Fine. You can accept your wrong, or we'll be rid of you permanently. Either way, I win.
Ooh. That would have been a nasty cat bite.
You had every chance to look the other way. But here we are. You chose this.
Spare me the justifications, coward!
If anyone asks, I'll say you were transforming. Don't expect to be mourned.
Oh, for the love of God. Ladies, please. Ugh. No time for cat bites, all right? Alright, take three.
Asks, I'll say you were transforming. Don't expect to be mourned.
That's better. Third time was the charm.
She's a liability. It's the artifact we need, not her.
Let me up, and I'll show you.
Can I do that, Lazel? Can I turn my back on you?
Never. Thieves aren't afforded such luxury.
Loosen the grip on your pride for one blasted moment, won't you? We needn't be enemies. There's plenty of those to go around already.
What would you have? That we be friends?
Let's not get ahead of ourselves. Imagine what we might achieve if we channeled some of that hostility back at our real foes, instead of each other. They wouldn't stand a chance.
Oh. Bed rolls and breakfast. Alright. Save again and we'll go right back to work. But I wonder if that really is true, though, that if you do gain experience through successful persuasions. Anyways. Anywho, we got one more goblin leader to kill. What's this? Alright, so like I said, that's two goblin leaders down. We have one more to go.
Need to find a way forward.
But it's like I've said before, I'm very surprised that we didn't learn anything new in our quest. So like I said, we have two down, one to go. So where's this last leader at? It's right over there, but he's below us. Like I said, we're not going to do anything rash as of yet. Alright, so how do we get down? Large giant spider. Ooh, lovely. Use grubby key. Huh. That's cute. Six. Yikes. Absolutely nothing. It accomplished absolutely nothing. Job. That little purple thing is. Oh, weapon was dropped. Oh, wait. Mm-hmm. I still want to know what that purple thing is. Down for the count.
Another parasite. Collect it. It might be useful.
That sounds like I'm over encumbered. Who's proficient with a musical instrument besides a bard? Oh, these are just little guys here. I think all three goblin leaders are dead. Nice shot. Way to go. Way to go, dude. You are the man with that crossbow.
Thank you.
So how was he able to shoot me? I gotta get back to town in the worst way here so I can start getting rid of some of these items. Let's take a look at these here. Evolve an area of your mind to embrace your potential. 3 tadpoles available, huh? Never mind. You, do you have anything of use? All three Goblin leaders are dead. We probably should head back to camp and rest up here, because that was quite a battle. Actually, I'm going to do some business with him.
Ah, my good fellow.
Quite the cozy setup you have here. I'll just make my research.
I assure you, I've dreamt of it.
But we will find a more learned opinion.
Second thought here.
You only have a matter of days.
Withers. What does he want?
Ah, another. Thy name has been recorded.
Who's this guy?
Here in thy camp, for whenever thou hast need of my services. There are many answers to that question. None. Correct. No. Beyond mortal realms, there doth exist an amalgamation of spirits akin to thine own, ensnared by the treacherous cult of the absent, felled in its name. They bear great discontentment with their destiny. For a mere pittance of coin, I might summon the worthiest among them to lend aid to thy undertaking. Suspicion always haunts the guilty mind. My services are all that I can proffer thee. What thou wilt do with them is for thee. Doth run deep for what hath been wrought upon them. Should thou or any of thy compatriots perish, I will cleave soul to body once more. Because it is my calling, there is little else to explain. Matter of coin.
200, huh?
Such is life. Outrage leading to a singular end.
This dude's probably the weirdest character out of all the,
Very well.
Second thought. Here there's... This strange wraith commands many powers. He allows you to resurrect allies, hire help, and change a class. For a price, of course. Aww. You're not just gonna do this out of the kindness of your... of your undead heart. Oh, him. What does he want?
You know, I was just thinking about you. Remembering our little encounter. The very same. It obviously put me off your neck, but now I can't help but wonder how the others taste.
Oh, for love of God.
And not that anyone's volunteered. It's just an idle fancy. Oh, you're a sweetheart. But you don't need to worry. I'm just thinking out loud.
Right.
Take Gale, for example. He strikes me as someone whose blood is rich, refined, like well-aged brandy.
But the gift?
What in the hell's would she taste like?
Why don't you try for yourself?
Yes. Heavens forbid we have an interesting conversation. Still, I am intrigued by the possibilities. Relax. We're just talking. So, in the spirit of theoretical questions, if you had to take a bite from one of them, who would it be? Oh, no. No. Don't be disgusting. I just mean a sip of their blood. No mastication required. What? I was only making conversation. Honestly, you have no sense of fun.
New feet, huh? You know what? Let's improve one of our abilities here. Or I should rather... Let's do this. Because it seems like I'm not having very much luck with the wisdom and charisma. I think this will be just fine. Let's see what she has. She has very high wisdom. But intelligence isn't very high. You'd think for a cleric here she'd have higher intelligence, but I guess that's not entirely the case. So let's increase her intelligence. Let's get her dexterity up. Yeah, let's make her tougher to hit. Make her a little more accuracy with bows. Oh yeah, that's much better.
On drama. I'm glad Shadowheart and Lazel settled their differences peacefully. Eventually. We all have our burdens, one way or the other.
All right, anyways, back to the adventure. Perfect. Alright. So that takes care of the goblin leaders. They're all dead. Now it's time for us to get out of here. Someone walking around. Potion of healing nearby. I'll take that. Perfect. Although I think something tells me here we've probably got a lot of goblins to fight. And an ogre. Her, on the other hand, she doesn't care.
You bow or you break. Can't afford to let up. Let's make this quick.
Nice. Very nice. Asirin, you are the man. So to speak here. Dang, Asterion, you are just that deadly with a crossbow. Remember myself not to cross paths with you when you're in a bad mood. But I think he also has the highest dexterity. Sam, what would we do without you and your sharpshooting abilities? I have Before I do anything stupid, I better save it here. Because I know there's probably going to be a big fight coming up. Just as I suspected. But luckily, a lot of these goblins are very weak, so... Good, he's dead. It's a good thing the best part of these guys are little enemies. My god, there's just a lot of them. And quit picking on Shadowheart here. What did she do to you? Really? Am I coming with you? Really? Wow, what's with all these misses? Or rather, misters. Useless. All right, I think we better head back to camp. Because that was insane.
Any more trouble between Lazelle and I, if you were wondering. We can all sleep easier now. Well, apart from all the rest. Relax. We'll kiss and make up on our own time. Someone prodding at a newly opened wound doesn't help matters. I already know my biggest secrets. What more can you ask? What, besides my life's calling and the greatest problem I've ever faced? Well, I like night orchids and can't swim. Is that the sort of thing you meant? It's a deal. No, I can't. Quite literally, I mean. With my memory suppressed, I can't betray Shah's secrets. But I can't remember much of myself, either. If I manage to return to Baldur's Gate and fulfill Shah's mission, then my memories will be restored. Of course. It is an act of faith, not to be undertaken lightly. Shah will reward me when I succeed. one hand, they seem useful. But on the other hand, or perhaps tentacle before long, we know where they're coming from, and what lies at the end of that path. I never expected seramorphosis to be tempting. I think we should resist these powers. There's simply too many unknowns for us to risk it.
Alright, another persuasion. Crudsicles. There we go. It's much better.
On one hand, I never expected seramorphosis to be tempting. I think we should resist these powers. There's simply too many unknowns for us to risk it.
Oh, for the love of Jesus. My God. Really? And yes, I'm aware, difficulty of 15. But I've done this before. And besides, like I said, I think you can get experience out of this. But they have to be successful.
On one hand, they seem useful. But on the other hand, or perhaps tentacle before long, we know where... I never expected seramorphosis to be tempting. I think we should resist these powers.
Oh, Jesus Christ! This is really starting to wear my patience. And after getting through all those goblins and that ogre, I think we deserve a lot more. Or at least I deserve a lot more.
On one hand, I never expected seramorphosis to be tempting. I think we should resist.
Yes!
There's simply too many unknowns for us to risk. Well, perhaps you have a point. Fine. Let's explore these powers then. I just hope we don't come to regret it. The wound on my hand. It never quite heals. And sometimes it causes terrible pain to rip through me. It's my burden, though, from Lady Shah. I can feel her influence somehow. I'll try my best. But secrecy is ingrained in me. Lady Shah considers it greater protection than any shield or armor. It's less difficult than you might imagine. When you can't remember life without it. Pain is sacred to followers of Lady Shah. Pain will give way to loss and then to the peace of her eternal darkness. You can tolerate a great deal of suffering so long as it has meaning.
Uh-huh.
I cannot say. Not with what I can recall. But even then, it would not be for me to question her will. Lady Shah has her reasons. It's difficult to say. Sometimes I wonder if it's supposed to be guiding me, punishing me, testing me. But perhaps it's none of those. Perhaps it's completely random. I'd like to hope there's more to it than that. Some meaning that Lady Shah will reveal to me when the time is right. Until then, all I can do is endure.
false promises. The missing druid, Halsin, was it? He may be talented, but only a Githyanki safist can cleanse an embedded tadpole. Entirely. I was as devoted to my studies as I was to my training. Each creche contains a safest purification device. So I learned from the writings in the Kalir Library. The library was a gift from Vlakith herself, that we may gain total understanding. Countless scholars roam the astral sea and beyond, observing the ways of our lessers, exploring planes so distant order turns to chaos and cold fires rage. The planes are ever quaking, and their peoples ever shifting. The Githyanki possess an eternity of knowledge. Yet we still collect more. Infinities upon infinities. It is over where I am concerned. I will not be bearing the burden of the half-elf's deceit. She was the source of strife. I was the end of it. I suggest you turn your eye of judgment to her. Mark my words. This power would be no blessing, but a curse. You might as well ask me to gouge out my eyes for the promise of sight, or slice off my tongue for the promise of taste. Consume all the gate tadpoles you wish. I'm not so craven.
I got another one of these, so... On second thought, never mind. I am not gonna run the risk of a 20 here. Uh-uh. No way, I'm not gonna persuade her. If I knew it was going to be this hard, I wouldn't have done it in the first place. But now I know.
Consume the gate tadpoles.
Let's talk about something else. Yeah, let's skip on this for now.
I understand much beyond your comprehension. More to the point, I know the cure for our condition. It is imperative we locate a creche. You do well to observe more and question less. Yes, in great detail. It starts with a fever and memory loss. Then you start to hallucinate. Your hair falls out, and you bleed from every orifice. Your bones will change form. Your jaw will split to allow room for four great tentacles. All skin will turn to gore and be shed to reveal new flesh underneath. Then
that's
you have ceased to
quite
exist,
lovely.
And a mind flayer is born. I do not intend to let this happen. Not to me, and if you stick with me, not to you. We must find my kind and be rid of the parasite. It's as simple as that. The first symptoms should have long since started, though. That is what puzzles me. Yes, if you give it no further thought. But anomalies lead to surprises. Bad surprises. Besides, what hasn't happened may yet come to pass.
Mm-hmm. It's a good thing I did not do that speech check with her. I mean, a very good thing.
I just thought of something. Oh, you'll have to speak slowly. I'm finding it quite difficult to concentrate with my condition gnawing at my insides like a teething displacer kitten. That is most gratifying to hear. May I?
I'm gonna give that to Shadowheart. Gloves of Archery is way too valuable.
Thank you.
I'm willing to bet that more powerful artifacts are going to stave his hunger for a lot longer.
Spot. I can feel it work. The magic, it's like a lullaby that sings to sleep the demon inside. A metaphorical demon, I haste to point out, but no less dangerous. And no less bound to wake up again to continue its ravages. Such is the nature of all monsters. My words, my actions, my award-winning smile. Sincerely, though, I understand I ask a lot from you with few answers in return. But in time, all will be told.
I obtained it in Waterdeep. Nothing there comes cheap.
All right.
Setup you have here. I'll just make my.
Yeah. That's end of the day.
Away. No, she's no one, really. I was just practicing an incantation.
It's always a good idea to save before you do one of these.
What can I say? She's Mistra. I can't quite describe it. The need I sometimes feel to see her. To draw the filaments of fantasy into existence. No sculpture or painting could ever do her justice. Only the fabric that she herself is. And embodies. The weave. Mistra is all magic. As far as I'm concerned, she is all creation. Magic is my life. I've been in touch with the weave for as long as I can remember. There's nothing like it. It's like music, poetry, physical beauty, all rolled into one and given expression through the senses. Would you like to experience this? Disinterest is such a disheartening condition. Always a pity when opportunities slip us by. Good night.
All right, time to move on.
something I want to talk to you about. Something important. I could have died in that pod, back on the North Lloyd. You could have died, spending precious moments trying to free me, but you did it anyway. I owe you my life. Twice over, in fact. You supported me against Lazelle. I may not have survived that night without you. I'm trying to say that you've earned my trust in a way very few ever have. I want that to mean something. I want you to know more about me.
And just for the record, Shadowheart, Lazelle is within earshot.
As long as I've prayed to Lady Shah, I've wished to serve her as a Dark Justiciar. There is scarcely a greater way to fully dedicate yourself to Lady Shah, save perhaps if you become the head of her church. To become a Dark Justiciar is to become the Night Singer's sword arm. Her implement with which she will cast down the unbelievers and win the final battle to restore her perfect, endless darkness. It's all I ever wanted. I prayed it was my calling. But Mother forbid me from seeking to prove myself worthy of the rank. She said I was not ready. Not my mother, I should add. The Mother Superior. Head of Lady Shah's enclave in Baldur's Gate. Sometimes I wonder if she would ever deem me ready. I owe her everything, and I only wish to serve, yet she can prove inscrutable. I don't know. Perhaps if I succeed in my mission and reach Baldur's Gate, has little place amongst Lady Shah's children. It's an illusion, a distraction. For this, I hope my time will yet come. Dark Justiciars are hated by many, judged to be ruthless fanatics. Even the few who would accept a follower of Lady Shah would likely balk at a justiciar in their midst. But there's a simpler answer to your question. I simply forgot about the desire I had until I saw some things that reminded me. Now, I can't get it out of my mind.
Alright, so... Oh, right! I forgot there was one thing I was going to give Shadowheart. There was a special weapon here. What was it? Oh, this. Right. Never mind. Anyways, let's get going. A long track ahead of ourselves here. Plus, I'll take the arrow of acid, though. Grilled pork belly. Yum. And they said it was dwarf. Oh, there's the roasted dwarf leg right there. Well, I don't know if I'd want to eat a dwarf, though. I don't know. I guess we'll find out at some point. There. That's a pretty high way up, actually. How does one get up there, though? Nice. Really? You've been charmed again. Nice. Very nice shot. Yeah, missed. You mean to tell me there's actually no way to get up there? There's absolutely no way. Really? Like I said, there is always a way up. I just don't know how you're... I guess the only way you'd be able to do it is with spells. There's only one person who can do that sort of thing, and that's Astarion. Target. What do you call that? That's a target. Although now you actually put us in range, so nice job, stupid. That was not a... Oh, we got her. Nice work. It really wasn't too bad of a fight. Swift as my feet can carry me. My destination's up there, so let's get going. You know, I just realized something here. Since there's blood on the ground, I wonder if... I wish I could, but I can't.
This place yet, and I hear you are the one to thank. I'm grateful. I took a collection from all of us. It isn't much, but you've earned it. Very good of you. Thank you.
Halcyon will likely want to thank you too, mind. He returned just a while ago. I believe he's catching up with Corgo.
As for us,
no armies at our heels. Amazing. We can finally leave. But perhaps we need not speak of farewells. We'll join your camp tonight to celebrate if you'll have us.
Not right now, because I have some business to take care of. Or rather, some stuff to sell.
We're ready to head to your camp. Are you?
I'll be there in just a bit. Right now, I got business to take care of.
So it's true. You scattered the goblins. Peace can finally return to this corner of the Sword Coast. Thank you. As am I. And I'm sure those poor refugees would quite agree. Of course.
Torches we're gonna hang on to. Oof, 600. I think that's enough.
May you keep balance.
Thanks. All right, so let's find Planet Blade of Kaleth. I need Will. This one here. I'll worry about the seller another day. Oh, yeah, I'm gonna talk to the druid. But you know what? No. I'm actually gonna save this for another day. Oof. That was interesting, to say the least. Alright, I think on that note, I'll see you all next time.